Today I'm going to be showing you how to install R version 3.6.1 on your Mac computer. This is a two-step process. First we need to install XQuartz, and then we need to install the R program. You can find both of these programs by navigating in your internet browser to www.r-project.org. At the top of the screen, hit the Download R button, which will take you to a list of CRAN mirrors in order to download the software. These CRAN mirrors are just servers that host the information as well as the original site, so you should be getting the same information from all of them. However, we find that some of them tend to update faster than others, so we encourage you to use the one from the University of Michigan. Down here, https://repo.miserver.it.umich.edu. So I'm going to click on that one, and that takes you to the R installation page. We want to download R for macOS, and this will show you the different versions of R, starting with the most recent. Our most recent is R3.6.1. We want to install this one, but because we require XQuartz, we want to look at this note here first. Click on the XQuartz link to open a new web page. Now we want to complete the download for the XQuartz package. Simply click on that link and it will end up in your downloads folder. When it's finished, open downloads and open your package to install XQuartz on your computer. When it's finished, open this package, and the installer will guide you through the installation process. Continue, continue, agree, install. You may need to enter an administrator password if you have multiple user accounts on your computer. When XQuartz is finished installing, you should get this message, which says you will need to log out and log back in to make XQuartz your default server. We normally encourage you to restart your computer completely in order to complete this process. Press OK. And when the installer is finished, you can close it and then move the installer to the trash. Now we're going to restart the computer to ensure that XQuartz is determined to be the default server. Once your computer has finished restarting, open your internet browser again. Or it may have already opened if you told it to reopen Windows when you restart your computer. Navigate again to www.r-project.org and go through the same process where we hit the Download R button and scroll down to our mirror. Download R for Mac OS. And now we're back to the R project page. Here we want to click on this link over here, r-3.6.1.package, and this will download the R installer package. When that's finished downloading, open your downloads folder and click on that package to open up the installer. Press continue, 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 agree, install, again, possibly an admin password, install software, and this installer works pretty quickly as well. Close the installer once your installation is complete. Move to trash. Now we have both programs installed that we need. We can go up to the Finder, the little spotlight search here, and type just R. This is the R logo, so that's what you're going to be looking for when you go to open this program. Hit R. And this is the R console. What you want to do is type install.packages, parentheses, quote, capital R, CMDR, and then press enter or return. It's going to ask you again for a CRAN mirror. We are picking MI2, that's the University of Michigan CRAN mirror. Press OK. So now R is installing a list of packages that is required to create this R commander. This may take a few minutes. If you find that it's paused, wait until the arrow shows up at the very last line. If there's no arrow, that means that it's not done installing yet. Now that we have our arrow, we can go to the next step. Type in library, parentheses, quote, capital R, CMDR, and hit enter or return. This loads the required packages, but it will also ask for a few extra steps. The OTool command would like to install. We recommend installing it now to get it out of the way. It's not usually required for what you're going to be using it for, but it will prompt you every time you open R Commander to install it. So I'm going to hit install and agree on that. I'm going to continue on battery power because I can, and that will continue installing. R will give you a message that says the following packages are missing. These are ones that were missed in the first install we did, so just hit yes because you do require those packages. Install packages from CRAN, the CRAN mirror you selected earlier. Hit OK. And you can see it loading in the background here as it installs those extra packages. This is the R Commander window that you're going to be using for most of your statistical analysis. If we look down here in the warning messages, it says the Mac OS X version works best under R.app with AppNap turned off. You can turn AppNap off by going up to Tools, Manage Mac OS X AppNap, and turning that off. When closing the program, hit the red X button to exit, and then again on the R console. When R console asks you to close and save workspace image, you don't want to save it. It's not saving your work, it's saving the commands that you put into the R console. Doing this may corrupt your program if you've entered in the wrong commands, so please don't save it. And you're all set. In order to open up R for your classwork, you just have to type in R in your Spotlight search or add the program to your desktop or Finder. And then type library, parentheses, quote, capital R, CMDR. Hit enter. And it will load R Commander for you. And you're all set. If you have any problems or any trouble with install, feel free to ask a GSI or contact Blue Core in LSNA Technology Services. You can find more information about Blue Core and about R on your Canvas course.